Hey guys, this might be the last problem I will take up on convolution integral. And the problem is evaluate y of t is equal to u of t plus 2 minus u of t minus 1 convolved with u of 2 minus t. As a whole, this part is one signal which is x of t and this is another signal which is h of t. Okay, so solution. So let this is of the form y of t is equal to what? X of t convolved with h of t, right? So we'll assume we'll assign let x of t will be the first signal, which is this part u of t plus 2 minus u of t minus 1, and h of t is this one, u of 2 minus t. So we'll sketch these two signals first, later on we'll see what can be done. Okay, so this x of t input signal is what? The combination of these two, right? So we'll plot these two and then we'll subtract it. How does a u of t plus 2 looks like? This is nothing but u of t shifted left 2 time, right? So if this is minus 2 minus 1, this is 0, this is at t equal to 0, right? So this is goes up to infinity and its amplitude is 1. Okay, and this signal has to be subtracted with what? U of t minus 1. So how does a u of t minus 1 signal looks like? So this is at t equal to 0, u of t shifted right one time, no? Okay, so its amplitude is 1. Right, so this signal has to be subtracted with the second signal, which is u of t minus 1. So what we get is x of t, which is equal to what? U of t plus 2 minus u of t minus 1. So if we try to sketch this, this is t, this is at t is equal to 0, this is 1, this is minus 1, this is minus 2. Fine. So what is the amplitude of the first signal? For t varying from minus infinity up to minus 2, it is 0, right? What is the amplitude of the second signal? For t varying from minus infinity up to minus 2, this is also 0, right? 0 minus 0, we get 0. For t varying from minus infinity to minus 2. Fine. What is the amplitude of first signal for t varying from minus 2 to 1? This is 1. Minus 2 to 1, it is 1. What is the amplitude of the second signal for t varying from minus 2 to 1? It is 0. So 1 minus 0 is 1. So it is 1 for t varying from minus 2 to 1. What is the amplitude of the first signal for t varying from 1 to infinity? It is 1. What is the amplitude of the second signal for t varying from 1 to infinity? It is 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0. So it is 0. Basically, it's a rectangular pulse for t varying from minus 2 to 1 and its amplitude is 1. Right? Now, so h of t, this is actually, it is not in a standard form. I have to bring it in a standard form, something like u of minus t plus 2, right? How does the standard form looks like? It is of x of a t minus b. So, first has to be the independent variable, right? So, I bought the first term as independent variable. Now, this has both time scaling operation and time shifting operation. So this involves what? Precedence rule, right? Precedence rule. I need to apply precedence rule to perform this operation. So what does the precedence rule says? Whenever the signal involves both time scaling and time shifting operation, I have to perform time scaling operation on an intermediate signal v of t, right? So this v of t has only time shifting operation, right? So which is nothing but what? U of t plus 2. So while shifting, ignore the scaling part. While scaling, ignore the shifting part. Since I'm shifting the signal, I'm concentrating only on shifting part, which is plus 2, which is t plus 2, right? Call it with a intermediate signal v of t. So how does u of t plus 2 looks like? U of t plus 2 is nothing but u of t shifted left 2 time, right? So minus 2 minus 1 0 1 2 goes on. So it is like this. This is at t equal to 0. Right, now what I have to do is I have to time scale the intermediate signal. So now I have to scale the signal. Scaling is actually v of minus t, right? If I know v of t, if v of t signal is this, what is v of minus t? This signal is mirror image, right? I have to take this signal's mirror image. So this is at t equal to 0. When I take its mirror image, this goes to, minus t's amplitude goes to, sorry, minus 2's amplitude goes to 2 and the other amplitude comes left side, right? This is 2. Okay, so this is how the signal looks like. It is starting from minus infinity and ends at So this is t. And what is this actually? This is nothing but what? If v of t is u of t plus 2, what is v of minus t? In this right hand side equation, replace t by minus t, right? Which is nothing but u of minus t plus 2. And what is this? U of 2 minus t. And what is the signal? What is the signal? It is nothing but h of t, right? Okay. So we got x of t, we got h of t, right? So we'll plot it separately. So step one. So we'll sketch x of t. X of t is varying from minus 2 to 1. Its amplitude is 1. This is minus 1. This is 0. This is at t equal to 0. This is x of t. So how does an h of t looks like? So h of t signal is this, right? So it is starting from minus infinity till 2. This is 0, this is 1, this is 2. This is at t equal to 0. So starting from minus infinity till 2. Fine. What is the next step? So I have to bring this to the tau form, right? So I have to replace independent variable from t to tau. So this is minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1. This is tau, this is x of tau. Now I have to take the mirror image of this, which is h of minus tau. So when I take mirror image, this goes to minus 2, so minus 1, 0. So this just flips with an axis t equal to 0, right? So this is at t equal to 0. This is tau. Fine. So we got x of tau, h of minus tau. What is the next thing I need to do? I have to plot both the sequence in the same independent variable, which is tau. So x of tau is varying from minus 2 to 1, and h of minus tau we'll keep just before x of tau. X of tau, we'll keep the signal just before x of tau. I'll keep it here. Okay. So what is this? Since this is at minus 2, this is nothing but t minus 2, right? Okay. So where does the overlap start? So overlap starts from minus 2, and where does the overlap ends? Overlap ends at 1, because two signal meets at tau minus 2 to 1. For the other range, we have only one signal, no? So the thing is, this t minus 2, if I take this sequence, t minus 2 slider, when I take this t minus 2 slider is nothing but I am taking this, the signal is h of minus tau. I am taking this h of minus tau signal, and if I keep it to minus infinity and move on from minus infinity till just before minus 2, the overlap portion does not change. It remains same, right? So therefore t minus 2 is less than minus 2. If I write it in terms of t, so t is less than 0. Because minus t goes to the other side, so minus 2 goes to the other side, minus 2 plus 2 is 0. So for t is less than 0, so what is the output y of t? Y of t is nothing but integrating from where does the overlap region starts? Minus 2. Where does the overlap region ends? 1. So what is the amplitude of the first x of tau? It is 1. What is the amplitude of h of t minus tau? It is also 1. So 1 times 1 d tau. So x of tau, h of t minus tau, d tau. Right, so integration differentiation cancels out, so I end up with tau with the limit minus 2 to 1. This is nothing but 1 upper limit minus of minus 2 lower limit, which is equal to 3. So for t less than 0, my output is 3. It's a constant. Why? Because the overlap portion does not change, it remains same no matter wherever I keep t minus 2 from minus infinity just before minus 2, right? Okay, so now the second overlap portion, I have to move this t minus 2 somewhere right till somewhere in between minus 2 to 1, right? If this is minus 2 and this is 1, I'll move the slider in between minus 2 to 1. So this is my t minus 2 and this is tau. Where does the overlap starts? It starts from t minus 2 and ends at 1. Okay. So now, what is the condition now? So for t minus 2, I did not include minus 2, I will include now minus 2 greater than or equal to minus 2. In the sense, this slider greater than or equal to minus 2, and till where I can move this slider, till 1, right? So and t minus 2 is less than or equal to 1. So if I write it in terms of t, this is t is greater than or equal to 0, and t is minus 2 goes to the other side, plus 2, it is 3. So y of t is less than or equal to 3. So t is in between 0 to 3, right? If t is in between 0 to 3, what is y of t? Y of t is equal to what? Integrating from t minus 2 to 1. T minus 2 to 1, x of tau, h of t minus tau, both are 1, so d tau. Integration differentiation cancels out. This is equal to tau with the limit t minus 2 to 1. This is nothing but t minus 2 minus 1, which is nothing but t minus 3. Okay, I'm sorry, upper limit minus lower limit. So this is 1 minus of t minus 2. So this is equal to 1 minus t plus 2. This is nothing but 3 minus t. So this is the output for t varying from 0 to 3. Okay. If I move it right further, what happens? I'll write it here. So I'll be moving it right further. So this is my x of tau minus 2 to 1, and if I move it right further, this is h of minus tau, this is t minus 2, this is x of tau, this is h of t minus 2, right? So now what is the condition for t minus 2? I included 1 here, so I stood 1 here, so greater than 1. Write it in terms of t. So t is greater than 3. So what is y of t? Y of t is equal to 0. Why? Because we won't get any overlap, since no overlap, right? So combining the output, we get y of t equal to what? 3 for t less than 0, and it is equal to 3 minus t for t in between 0 to 3. And is equal to 0 for t greater than 3. So this is the whole system output